Good afternoon to everybody. For a few days, I am asked by some of the peoples from South India as well as from North India to deliver the speeches in special education, in the different aspects of special education, either in English or in Hindi. And therefore, today I am trying to my best to deliver a speech in English, and it will be continued for the next days until and unless I will be able to complete my speeches, my lectures, my voices regarding the sensitization of challenged people. My today's lecture is spinal cord injury. Spinal cord, it occurs. The spinal cord injury occurs when the spinal cord is traumatized or severed through extreme extension or flexing. Usually arise from accident or injuries or fall. Injury to the spinal column is usually described by letters and numbers indicating where the damage occurred. For example, C5 to 6 injury means that the damage occurred at the level of 5th and 6th cervical vertebrae, a flexible area of the neck susceptible to injury. This is the neck region. This is the neck region. So in this region, the cervical vertebrae are present. When injury occurred in vertebrae number 5th and 6th, then it is termed as the cervical vertebrae 5th to 6th. A T12 injury occurred at the 12th thoracic vertebrae. Here is the thorax. It is the thorax and thoracic vertebrae just present behind the thorax. So, in the 12th number of thoracic vertebrae, when just behind the chest, when it is affected, when it is injured, it is termed as the T12 injury. And an L3 at the third lumbar area, that is the lower back area. In the lower back area of the body, the vertebrae are termed as the lumbar vertebrae, and the third lumbar vertebrae, when it is affected, it is termed as the third lumbar area. In general, there is paralysis and loss of sensation below the level of injury. Injury occurred in the neck or upper back causes paralysis, which is much extensive in nature. In injury occurred in the lower back, paralysis confined to the lower extremities. I have already told that the paralysis occur just after the place of injury. Accompanying damages of spinal cord injury are head trauma, 15% cases, fractures of some portion of the trunk, 20% cases, and significant chest injuries, 15% cases. So, accompanying damages of the spinal cord injuries are head trauma, 15% cases, fractures of some portion of the trunk, 20% cases, and significant chest injuries in 15% cases. Topographical description of paralytic conditions arises from spinal cord injury. Just like the cerebral palsy, the nomenclature on the basis of topography, that is the area of the body where damage occurred and where the areas are affected. In monoplegia, area affected is one limb, generally either one hand, that is upper limb, or one lower limb, that is one leg. Paraplegia. In paraplegia, the affected area is lower body and both legs. Lower body and both the legs are affected in paraplegia. In hemiplegia, it is the affected area is one side of the body. In hemiplegia, one side of the body, either the right side or the left side of the body, is affected in hemiplegia. In triplegia, three appendages or limbs. Three appendages or three limbs, like two hands, one leg, or two legs and one hand, usually both legs and one arm. In triplegia, the three appendages or limbs, like two legs and one arm, it is the major affected area. In quadriplegia, all the four extremities and usually the trunk, all the four extremities, that is the two hands, two legs, as well as the trunk, that is the body part, is also affected. Diplegia, legs more affected than arms. In diplegia, legs are more affected than the arms. In double hemiplegia, both halves of the body, that is the right half of the body as well as the left half of the body, both halves of the body with one side more affected than the other. Both halves of the body are affected, but maybe the right side of the body is more affected than left side, or the left side of the body is more affected than the right side. The question arises, what types of intervention strategies we can provide when an individual is affected from spinal cord injury? The first step of intervention of spinal cord injury is trauma and shock management, following by bowel and bladder control. The first step of intervention of spinal cord injury is trauma and shock management, following by bowel and bladder control. Steps may be taken to reduce swelling and bleeding at the injury site. Tractions may be used to stabilize certain portions of the spinal column and cord. Rehabilitation programs involves occupational therapy, physiotherapy, use of wheelchair and other adaptive devices for mobility and independent living. Patient with spinal cord injury are prescribed to use hand splint, brushes, reachers, head sticks for typing, and plate guards. Adult and adolescent spinal cord injury patients are concerned about sexual function. According to culture, gratification of sexual needs can be arranged. A team of orthopedic surgeon, rehabilitation psychologist, and counselor, special educator, and social worker, as well as the physiotherapist and occupational therapist, are needed for providing full rehabilitation services. In this type of patients, the major part played by the role regularly. Major part or the major role played by the occupational therapist. Without the support of occupational therapy, the spinal cord injury patient's rehabilitation become affected. Okay, thank you all.